Hey, I'm photographer David Bergman, and this is 2 Minute Tips for Adorama TV. When I do portfolio reviews for photographers, there's a problem I see over and over, and I'm on a quest to fix it. They often show too many images and haven't learned to edit tight. When I started in this business years ago, I was a staff photographer at the Miami Herald. We shot our assignments and then would come back to the office where we'd process the film and bring it out to the desk. A seasoned photo editor would go through all of our images one by one and look for the single frame that captured each event. Then we'd go into the darkroom and print those images and only those images. This is how I learned to edit. I hate to sound like an old man yelling at the kids to get off his lawn, but in today's digital world, the art of photo editing is kind of going away. This is especially true if you're just shooting for yourself and don't have an editor to help you. If you're on your own, you need to have an unbiased eye and be able to pick the absolute best images. It doesn't matter how hard you worked to make the photo, what matters is that the final image is actually good. If you aspire to be a professional and are sending out portfolios, it's much better to show 10 strong images. The worst thing someone can say at that point is that you just don't have enough experience. But each image is actually really great. If you show 20 pictures with half of them being weak, it waters down the whole thing and your portfolio is just average. That's not gonna make a lasting impression. Even if you're just posting vacation photos on Facebook, no one except your mother is actually gonna look at 100 pictures. Go through them very carefully and pick single images that each add something to the collection. Here's a tip, and keep this in mind when you're shooting. It's best to show images from various focal lengths. So some you want to be wide angle, some medium range, and some really tight telephoto. Each one of these can tell a different part of the story and make the final edit a lot more interesting to look at. Of course, art is subjective, but at the end of the day, you want every image you show to be there for a reason. Go for quality over quantity. Thanks for joining me today on Adorama TV. Don't forget to subscribe for more amazing videos. Follow me on social media @David Bergman and go to the Adorama Learning Center for lots of other great tips and tricks.